And the bottom card.
How are you doing?
Very well, thanks. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you enjoying your acting career so far?
I'm enjoying it, thanks.
Let's say that I'm your fairy godmother.
Okay.
And you say, "Helly, fairy godmother, can you just adjust things and take a few of the bad bits away?" What would the bad bits that you want me to
I'd
take away?
I'd quite like, I love doing the job, love working with people we work with. I'd quite like no one to ever watch it.
That's exactly what I think,
yeah.
too.
Because that's where it gets ruined,
yeah,
isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah. It's also, I'd prefer not to watch it.
Yeah.
And not anyone to watch it. It's kind of nice. Up till now, we've been in this bubble, and this is never going to come out. But now it's suddenly going to come out.
That's where it all goes wrong.
What's the question you don't want me to ask you?
Tell us some funny stories from on set.
Yeah. Or can you tell me, how did you research for this part?
My friends on set. What?
Yeah,
research
yeah.
the part.
Yes, can you tell me about that? How do you approach the part?
How did you approach the part? Hello. You tell me.
It's very funny because I think we're utterly different on that bit. We are quite different. I think we're quite similar in some things, but I think I do everything and you don't do anything. But she's amazing. I mean, you are a phenomenon. But I think you're quite private about what you do.
Maybe that's what it is. That's makes
so
it
in fact,
better.
I think you do a lot, but you just pretend that you don't do anything. I think you must have a photographic memory. Do you have a photographic memory? How do you learn your lines? Just out of... I know a lot of people don't like talking about it, and I know you don't like talking about it, because there's a sort of...
But.
But how do you, actually?
I don't do it any differently to anyone else.
How do you know?
Well, I presume because I don't have a photographic memory.
You don't?
No, so you do have to sit there and... Short scenes, I won't bother learning until on the day.
Really?
Because I don't think there's room in my head to... Some people learn stuff for a whole week. I can't do that.
See, if I left it to the day, I go, like, I get too panicked.
But only a short scene.
Yeah, even a short scene. Ah. I can't, it won't stick. I'm going to have cue cards everywhere. It's going to be a disaster.
You won't, just literally a little scene. Maybe if you had a couple of lines, you wouldn't have to learn that in advance.
No, I want to feel. I can't absorb.
I quite like the
panic. Do you like the adrenaline?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've got a few friends who like the adrenaline.
You know, the end of a day when they haven't... Everyone's a little bit panicked and everyone needs that we got to finish at 6. I love that.
And you can only do a few takes.
I love that.
Yeah, you like that bit. Is it when you're knackered and you're at the end of the day?
But that's sort of, it's like a coffee, isn't it? It sort of really picks you up.
Yeah, so you're a bit of an adrenaline junkie, possibly.
Maybe. That's what, never thought that.
Okay, the best bit and the worst bits. So what are the best bits of this job and the worst bits?
The best bits are... Well,
the
meeting,
acting bit.
Making friends.
Yes.
That's always the best bit.
Yeah.
Because like-minded people, you always find them on a set, don't you?
Yeah.
Cast and crew.
Yeah.
Love that. I love it when it's well written. I love being in a scene that's really beautifully written.
Yeah, it makes us look better.
You feel it.
Yeah.
Yeah, and it's great.
And it takes off.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you can feel that. Worst bits. 5 a.m. get-ups.
Yeah. It's just not possible. Not feasible.
I'm much better at 5 a.m. I mean, being on time than I am. Once the kids are awake, then I'm screwed.
So, actually, in a way, it's better that you wake up at 5 because they're not...
Well, then I wake up and 10 minutes
you have
I'm
your solitary time. You can have your own time. How to juggle
don't
those
really
two.
Don't like my own time.
No. No, I love my own time.
Yeah, that's see, where that's we differ.
We are very different.
What's your
way.
Best and worst?
The best bit is when I read a script and it's great writing.
Yeah.
And I go, I could do this and I could do that. Yeah. And I've got all these ideas and possibility is
I
just
don't
endless.
Have any ideas.
That's the difference between me. So I get too many ideas and I get optionitis, but it's just so exciting. And then I dream and start dreaming. I could do this and I could do that.
Optionitis. So you picked different ways of doing it?
All the time.
God.
Yeah, I love choice. We could do it this way, we could do it that way. And the better the writing, the more choices you have. And that excites me.
So gosh, I see that quite differently.
Totally different. Isn't it interesting?
The better the writing, the more I think I know exactly where I'm meant to go.
Well,
and if the writing's bad, then I think, oh God, I've got to come up with some ideas.
No, that's true. That's true too. But it's also the good thing about, I find the worst writing, you've got to find one way or one choice that makes it work. The better the writing, you could do it many, many different ways.
And it'll still be good.
Still be good. And then it's up to you to go
hang on.
But it's sort of, so that's the best bit is before you do it. The worst bit is when you watch it.
Yeah, when you get
and
the
I
job. The best bit's here.
Is when getting the job.
Yeah.
And then it's like, ha! And then, from then on, and the idiocy of this profession is, you really want a job, then you get the job, and then you're racing through the schedule and going like, when I got my days off. Yeah. It's so stupid.
I think every actor's like that, aren't they?
Yeah. We're pathetic. But the worst bit is actually watching. I can't bear watching. Can you
don't
watch
mind,
yourself?
No, I don't mind watching. I don't want anyone else to watch it. That's the problem. No. I don't mind watching.
You don't mind watching yourself?
No.
That's so interesting.
But do you mind it?
I hate it.
Why?
It's never what I thought it was going to be. I had
I know,
all this dream.
There's definitely moments where I think, oh, wish I'd done that differently.
But I'm always trying to get out of myself.
I think I'm thinking I probably see it as worse than somebody else does.
No, we all can't judge ourselves. And also, I don't think we can... I feel like I'm in a sort of like... It's a bit of a narcissistic way of watching because you're always going like, me, me, me. And in fact, you're not seeing the story, so you don't see what... You're not seeing the context. There's so much that perverts our perception.
I do love watching... To watch, for example, scenes that you've done with Ben Daniels... I wasn't present at. I love watching.
Yeah, I like seeing scenes that other people that I'm not in.
Yeah. On in a job, because we're lucky, we get to learn to do different things.
Yeah,
like
I love
horse
that.
Riding.
Yes.
Or have you
what have
learned
you had to learn as, to do?
Well,
walk.
Can't do that.
No, that's something we have in common. We can't walk.
We can't. We both walk like farmers.
No, we can't
walk
in
farmers,
high heels.
But it's not what royalty's meant to walk like.
No. We can't do high heels.
Can't do. Look at us both. Here we are. We've got platform trainers and sandals and Paris.
Any wide shot, don't. It's not fortunate.
I have to say, I thought I was bad in heels. Then I met you. It's amazing. Bambi on ice.
But I just think, honestly, what they're implements, they're stupid things. Yeah. They're torture.
And they can be very pretty.
They can be pretty, but they hurt.
They hurt, yeah.
And I can't stand up. And I can't get from A to B. And honestly, Amy, who I love, I really love.
It's an incredible.
She's not given me
designer.
One shoe that fits my foot.
She's. Oh my God, I've seen that.
I love her.
I've seen at least 20 shoes in your.
Yeah, what about your shoes? Did they fit your foot?
Well, they're all right.
She likes you better than.
No,
she's got it in for my feet.
She's tried. She's had about 20 shoes out for you. Maybe.
Oh, they don't work.
She just unless they're trainers.
I mean,
you're
they're
not
normal
happy.
Feet. They're reasonably normal.
They're
very
little
feet.
But they can't.
But they're honestly. They seem to be a puzzle, an impossibility for her. The bits I don't like are sitting still, having hair and makeup done. They're brilliant, but you know that you've got to be there for them and still, and I can't sit still very, very well for 2.5 hours.
No, and you're
plus,
also...
my music choice is not helpful.
So we all of us are in a makeup van together.
All in a row.
So that, and sure enough...
Lots of chats.
Lots of chats.
This is 5 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah. I particularly enjoy... annoying Tobias because he's
Tobias
quite
in the
quiet
middle.
And quite sensible
and
he's
wears
working.
His earphones
wears
too.
His earphones so I keep going TM and asking him questions and I know that he's just being sweet because he actually wants to go fuck off.
He's not he beams himself
bless
me up
him he has
Scotty.
To sit between us that's awful
it's not good for him
but Helena has the most extraordinary
bad
playlist for in the makeup van.
It's perfect. She thinks it's spa music. Should we play a little? We could
No. Don't put anyone through it. We sometimes text each other behind you going, what the fuck is this that she's playing?
Oh, is that what happened?
Yeah.
And then there was a song that was a really nice one. It was a nice
little
lally.
It was a ridiculous.
The Yurt
Welcome
song.
In my Yurt song. It was a...
But we don't want to have full on. If you had
every
way,
day for 8 months,
you would be in a festival from 5 o'clock.
I bought Sue David, my makeup artist, disco lights.
Yes, you had a disco.
Well,
we
that's
had
not
a disco.
What everybody wants.
Yes,
early,
at 5 o'clock.
I do understand.
Your
that.
Energy is prodigious. Mine isn't. I spend most of my time horizontal and having snoozes.
At lunchtime today, I said, Ellie, should we have lunch together? And she said, you can have 10 minutes of eating and talking, and then I will be lying down, and you can lie down next to me, but silence after that. Oh, no, thanks. I'll go and chat to everyone else.
Well, you can chat to other... You know, you've got amazing stamina. We have different energy levels. I come up and then I die, and then I need to have a snooze. And my hot water bottle.
And I like a snooze, but not when we're all together.
No,
to
I
chat.
Know. But you last. You've got all these reserves.
What happened?
And we've also got another 6 months, Collie.
Yeah.
We have to... And we're seeing each other tonight. Months. You know, I think we should have a snooze at lunch. Pace yourself. But you don't have any...
No.
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 We've got the new young blood.
Yeah, I've got the young blood. That'll be a test to our stamina, won't it? Yeah. I might turn out the time.
I think you'll be fine. They're young, but they're all great and hilarious. Erin is hilarious.
Oh, God, she's brilliant. Anne.
And it is fun to watch everybody see what they do. And Josh is brilliant.
Love that Erin. She's all right.
Yeah.
How's it going? Yeah, nice. And then she suddenly becomes,
really?
She's amazing.
She is amazing.
Yeah. They are already. I do find sometimes, you know, when you're working with someone who's really good.
Yeah, and then you come out.
Oh, that was good.
Yeah, and they go like, oh, my life.
My turn. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, do you remember that? The first scene, that was funny.
No.
The first scene we actually did together.
No.
You actually put earplugs in. You didn't have to listen Sorry. To me. No, it was very funny. I thought it was hilarious.
That sounds rude. That was not as rude as it sounds. Because she was saying very upsetting
things. Very sad things. And you're extraordinary.
My character was meant to be much stronger than I am. And well, I kept going, no, that's not how the Queen would react. So I had to listen. The brilliant sound department came up with the shipping. They've tuned into the shipping forecast. And I had it in my ears.
It was extraordinary. So she wasn't listening to me. I had this long spiel. And I could see Olivia's sort of faraway look.
South at Sarah, north at Sarah.
And then she'd look at me, because she had one line to say, and then go, Yes, and then Marion was being the Queen Mother in front of me, and then there was this one on the shipping forecast. I thought this is very, very funny. Very, very funny. But then you did take the earplugs out after.
Yeah, see? Didn't do it all in every scene we had together.
Maybe you have and you haven't been telling me.
I'm listening to
all your festival music. I know you don't really like talking about it, but you are amazing.
It's all about work again, aren't you?
Yeah. I just want to... Because it's funny, like, it is very private. I don't want to pry whether it's too private. But is there anything that you do, like, to get into... Do you do any thinking? About this part?
Yes,
and then but on an unconscious level.
But it's written so beautifully, and you've got great voice coaches.
Yes, that's right.
And then there's not an awful lot else to do,
is there?
Tell me the funniest thing you've done to get into character. And I know the answer already, but I just want you to tell everyone.
Which one, the farting? Or the... Because that's not intentional. No. Margaret?
Yes.
Which one? Head back? I do a bit of a head back.
No, who did you approach to help you get...
Oh, the medium.
Yeah.
Oh, that's just...
I still think that's really funny.
It's a bit...
I love you very much.
Why
did
not?
Someone in the last press junket said, so they spoke to... So we heard that Helena approached a medium. Did you approach a medium? No, because the Queen's
alive.
Still alive.
Somebody yesterday did say, really, really clever, lovely man, photographer, said, like, so did you get to meet her? Did you have to meet her? Kind of, she did. But,
kind of.
But... No, I'm very anal, so no stone unturned. So I thought, well, why not give it a whirl?
Yeah.
Meet a medium and see what they come up with. And actually,
Was it helpful, though?
I think it was, because first of all, the first thing that she said was...
The medium or Margaret?
Well, it was via the medium. Obviously, Margaret wasn't. Okay. But the medium, who is a friend of mine, who's a psychic and generally
helps gets
people.
Paid.
She did get paid, but not an inordinate amount. So I know where your head's going. Take total advantage of me. But so the first thing that she said, apparently, she said, oh, Margaret's here. I said, oh, really? Because I was actually doing it for other reasons. And she said, oh, well, we might as well talk to her since she's come. And said, like, she's in full regalia. She said, she does like the fact I'm playing. I'm a better choice than the other actor they were thinking of. So that's good. But that's
unless
such
the other
a typical,
actors watching this.
I don't know. No, I know. But that's a very typical thing that she gives you a compliment and then also sort of puts you down at the same time. She said, it was about time that I scrubbed up. That's very Margaret. She said...
Or was it your friend just wanting to say?
Maybe. Yeah, it was funny enough, when she contacted my great-granny had the same thing. It's like, it's enough of this eccentric dressing you've got. Can you just be elegant now?
You're elegant.
Today I'm elegant.
You're so beautiful.
Oh, thank you. But I haven't, not every day.
You are. You're always very elegant.
No, I'm not.
Well, I think you are.
Thank you. The one thing that I thought this was a good note from her, she said, remember that the cigarette holder is as much a weapon for expression as just, you know, satisfying my an addiction.
Oh, that's good.
That's pretty articulate.
Yeah.
What was about it? Scrub up. And then once I did meet her, that was another thing. And I did think that's pretty ironic. But she said to me...
You did meet?
I met her years ago, before she died, obviously. In my early 30s. And she said, oh, you are getting better, aren't you? And that was a sort of, I just thought, that's a very typical. Now I got, there's something rather ambivalent about her. She was always, she complimented, but she'd take it away, yeah. And she was always slightly difficult to place. And it's that prickly sort of atmosphere.
Which is what makes her such a wonderful character.
Yeah. Beautiful. She's complicated. And she's not easy. Not easy to be, I don't think, but fun to play. And you can do it many, many ways, and it'd be appropriate.
But we don't have many ways with the people that we're playing, because, I mean, I couldn't play the Queen Welsh.
You definitely couldn't play a Welsh, but you could try. That is not Welsh, is it? I don't know what we are going.
We're going all over Europe.
But we can do. No, the Queen, is the whole point about the Queen is so consistent.
Yeah.